Good morning, my dear students. Today we are going to continue the same lesson, History, Unit 4, People's Revolt. Vellore Revolt. The family members of Tipu were imprisoned at Vellore Fort after the Fourth Mysore War. It was quite natural that they were all unhappy and they hated the English. The Vellore Fort consisted of large majority of Indian troops. A good part of it recently been raised in Trinalveli after the Palayakarar uprising of 1800. Many of the trained soldiers of the various palayams were admitted into the English army. Thus the Vellore Fort became the meeting ground of the rebel forces of South India. In 1803, William Cavendish Bentinck became governor of Madras. During his period, certain military regulations were introduced in 1805 and 6 and were enforced by the Madras Commander-in-Chief Sir John Cradock, but the sipahis felt that these were designed to insult them. Causes for the revolt. The strict discipline, new weapons, new methods and uniforms were all new to the sipahis. The sipahis were asked to shave the beard and to trim the moustache. The wearing of religious mark on the forehead and the use of earrings were also banned. The English treated the Indian sipahis as their inferior. There was the racial prejudice. Immediate cause. In June 1806, Military General Agnew introduced a new turban resembling a European hat with a badge of cross on it. It was popularly known as Agnew's turban. Both the Hindu and Muslim soldiers opposed it, so the soldiers were severely punished by the English. Course of the revolt. The Indian soldiers were waiting for an opportunity to attack the English officers. On July 10th, in the early morning, the native sipahis of the 1st and 23rd regiments started the revolt. Colonel Fancourt, who commanded the garrison, was their first victim. The fort gates were closed. Meantime, the rebels proclaimed Fateh Haider as their new ruler. The British flag in the fort was brought down. The tiger stripe flag of Tipu Sultan was hoisted on the fort of Vellore. Suppression of the revolt. Major Coote, who was outside the fort, rushed to Ronipet and informed Colonel Gillespie. Colonel Gillespie reached Vellore Fort. The revolt was completely suppressed and failed. Peace was restored in Vellore. The revolt was suppressed within a short period. It was one of the significant events in the history of Tamil Nadu. Effects of the Vellore revolt. The new methods and uniform regulations were withdrawn. The family of Tipu, as a precautionary measure, was to send to Calcutta. William Cavendish Bentinck was removed from his service. Causes for the failure of the revolt. There was no proper leadership to guide the soldiers properly. The rebellion was also not well organized. Divide and rule policy of the English split the unity of the Indians. The revolt of 1857 or the First War of Indian Independence. The early uprisings did not succeed in threatening the British in India. The revolt of 1857 was a product of the character and the policies of colonial rule. The cumulative effect of the British expansionist policies, economic exploitation and administrative innovations over the years had adversely affected the positions of all rulers of Indian states. Causes of the revolt. The most important cause of revolt 1857 was a popular discontent of the British policy of economically exploiting India. Policies of doctrine of lapse, subsidiary alliance, and policy of effective control created discontentment among the people. The conversion activities of Christian missionaries were looked upon with suspicion and fear. Abolition of practices like sati, female infanticide, support to widow remarriage, and female education were seen by many as interference in their Indian culture by the Europeans. The Indian sepoys were looked upon as inferior beings and treated with contentment by their British officers. They were paid much less than the British soldiers. And the immediate cause was the introduction of new Enfield rifle in the army. The top of the cartridge of this rifle was to be removed by the mouth before loading it in the rifle. The cartridges were greased by the fat of pig and the cow. The Hindus revered the cow. The Muslims hated the pig. The soldiers therefore determined to refuse their service and ultimately revolted. Thus, the primary and immediate cause of the revolt was the use of the greased cartridges. The outbreak of the revolt. On 29th March 1857 at Barakpur near Kolkata, Mangal Pandey, a young sipai from Bengal regiment, refused to use the greased cartridge and shot down his sergeant. He was arrested, tried and executed. When this news spread, many sipais revolted. Course of the revolt. On 10th May 1857, the sipais of the 3rd Cavalry at Meerut openly revolted. They were immediately joined by the men of the 11th and 20th Native Infantries, and they murdered some English officers and then marched to Delhi and declared of Bahadur Shah II as the Emperor of India. Delhi became the center of the Great Revolt and Bahadur Shah its symbol. There were mutinies at Lucknow, Kanpur, Jhansi, Bareilly, Bihar, Faizabad and many other places in North India. Many other whose titles and pensions were abolished by the British who participated in it in order to take revenge. The Muslim leaders and Maulvis sought the opportunity of establishing the Muslim rule in India after turning out the British. In central India, the revolt was guided by Rani Lakshmibai of Jhansi. She was one of the greatest patriots of India. Suppression of the revolt. Lord Canning, the Governor General, took immediate steps to suppress the revolt. He collected the forces of Madras, Bombay, Sri Lanka and Burma. He ordered the loyal Sikh army to proceed to Delhi immediately. The British regained their lost positions very soon. Delhi was recaptured by General John Nicholson. On deportation of Bahadur Shah II rode to Rangoon, where he died in 1862. Sir Colin Campbell occupied Kanpur. The Rani of Jhansi had died in the battlefield. Kunwar Singh, Khan Bahadur Khan were all dead. The revolt was finally suppressed. By the end of 1859, British authority over India was fully re-established. The causes for the failure of the revolt. Various causes were responsible for the failure of the revolt: lack of organization, discipline, common plan of action, centralized leadership, modern weapons and techniques. The rebel leaders were no match to the British generals. Non-participation of Bengal, Bombay, Madras, Western Punjab and Rajasthan and Rajputana. The modern educated Indians did not support the revolts. The British managed to get the loyalty of the Sikhs, Afghans and the Gurkha regiments. The British had better weapons, better generals and good organization. Consequences of the revolt are the result of the revolt of 1857. The revolt of 1857 marked a turning point in the history of India. The administration of India was transferred from East India Company to the British Crown through the Queen's Proclamation in 1858. The Governor General was given the title of Viceroy. The Board of Directors and the Board of Control were replaced by the Council of 15 members headed by the Secretary of State to supervise Indian affairs. The Indian Army was thoroughly reorganized. More British were employed in the army. The British military policy came to be dominated by the idea of divide and counterpoise. The 1857 revolt came to be interpreted as a planned war of national independence by V.D. Savarkar in his book First War of Indian Independence. With this lesson is over, my dears. We will see the next lesson in the forthcoming online classes. Thank you, my dears.